Make a little contact here.
Yeah, fire.
Make contact with standard in the home.
Michael!
Chris King, the batter.
Good shot.
One more time.
say now, Biggin?
Mark Johnson, the batter.
Go!
Thank you. defeated Angus and Mecha Godzilla. But he's never faced an adversary like this. Godzilla versus Charles Barkley. It's the battle of the century. Get ready to see a real monster jam.
Dan Rather with a Democratic Convention update live from New York's Madison Square Garden. Jesse Jackson hit one out of the park here tonight with his Keep Hope Alive speech. The rhetoric was old-line Democratic Party, but Jackson backed the new generation ticket. He called Bill Clinton President Clinton. He called Al Gore tested and prepared. Also tonight, some hominy and some harmony. Jimmy Carter addressing the delegates and Jerry Brown turning down the volume on his fight with the Clinton camp. Also this evening, assembled delegates here approved a center-of-the-road Democratic Party platform to help the Clinton-Gore ticket go shopping for votes in the fall in America's malls and suburbs. Dan Rather at the Democratic Convention in New York. More later. Now back to the All-Star Game in San Diego.
The new pitcher for the National League is Bob Tewksbury. He steps into the spotlight with his team trailing 6-0. It's an all-new battery. Tewksbury of the Cardinals on the mound. Darren Dalton of the Philadelphia Phillies is the catcher. Down at the hot corner, hometown favorite Gary Sheffield of the San Diego Padres. Joe Carter, the hitter. He's working on a perfect night. Tewksbury's first pitch, a ball. Carter singled and scored in the first. He singled to drive in a run in the second. If you're just joining us, that's the first RBI ever by a Toronto Blue Jay in All-Star play.
It has been rare this season for Bob Tewksbury to go two balls and no strikes on anybody. He's walked 9 in 134 and two-thirds innings.
Ryan Sandberg calling for a fair catch in this, the home of the San Diego Chargers as well. One out in the fifth. The pictures you are seeing from the air are being provided tonight by the Bud One Airship, which is piloted by Tony Stevenson. Beautiful night for Tony to be up there. Mark McGuire takes an off-speed pitch from Tewksbury for his strike. He singled to drive in two runs in the first. He also scored in that inning. He faced Greg Maddux in the second and grounded out. Tewksbury's a native New Englander. He's from Concord, New Hampshire, making his first All-Star appearance. Routine pop-up. Again, it's Sandberg. Two down. And all of a sudden, National League pitchers, Maddux, Cone, and Tewksbury, have combined to retire 7 in a row. Cal Ripken Jr. singled to right, drove in a run in the first. He was thrown out trying to stretch that to a double. He flied to left in the third. Tim Hill takes his consecutive games played streak of 1,660 into the second half of the Orioles campaign.
And you realize how many games that he has played consecutively in pain. Lou Gehrig, 2,130 games in a row. If Ripken breaks his streak or ties it, it will be sometime in June of 1995.
Speaking of pain, it's fouled off his foot. It is particularly impressive when you consider that the second longest current game streak in Major League Baseball is 139 by Carlos Baerga of the Cleveland Indians, a fellow All-Star. Brett Butler at his snap to 235 for the Dodgers over the weekend.
And Joe Carter earlier in the year at 242 before he set out. But Cal Ripken has not set out since 1983. Actually, 82.
That's a foul ball. Battery taking no chances. And it is not a foul ball. It's an out. Ripken claiming the ball came up and brushed him off the arm, and it certainly looked like it did from here. Doug Harvey thinks he was just trying to buy a call, and that ends the inning.
Well, let's see if it came up and hit the shirt sleeve of Cal Ripken. It looks like it may have.
Definitely changed directions.
Doug Harvey didn't see it, so Ripken's the third out.
1-2-3, go the American Leaguers.
If Babe Ruth was alive, he'd be 2 years younger than me. Maybe it's the oysters.
Things are different. The new Pontiac Grand Am Sports Sedan proves it. Things are better because its new overhead cam engine gives you more than outstanding power. It gives you better mileage than Accord or Camry for a whole lot less. In fact, Consumer's Digest named Grand Am a Best Buy. Pontiac Grand Am. A new kind of driving excitement.
Bases loaded, two outs. As soon as it left his hand, I saw it left the bat. I knew it. And then you see all your teammates cheering and clapping. Anytime you hit a grand slam, it sort of doesn't get any better than that.
Capture the feeling of hitting a grand slam with Upper Deck Hologram card sponsored by Coca-Cola. A limited edition of 26 Grand Slam sluggers. Get one card free when you buy a new Grand Slam entree and a Coke Classic only at Denny's.
Well, and that's one of the proud moments where your chest sort of sticks out a little bit, and you say, yeah, that was it.
Well, I got a cop who wants me out of the way because he wants my wife.
Unlawful Entry is a smoothly crafted thriller. Kurt Russell and Ray Liotta are both great. Riveting bristles with tension and suspense. You don't need an air-conditioned theater. This movie has enough chills.
You go near her, I'll kill you.
Unlawful Entry, directed by Jonathan Kaplan. Rated R, now playing.
Back with the all-star of all-stars, Willie Mays. Played in 24 of these. I know it's tough, but you remember, what's your fondest one?
Well, I,